In this tutorial, I will show you how to fix you need the official WhatsApp to log in, an error that is experienced by modified WhatsApp users such as GB WhatsApp. So this is happening because WhatsApp Plus and GB WhatsApp are currently being blocked by WhatsApp as per their request, because these apps copy WhatsApp's app and do not meet the necessary security standards. And once you get that error, it means you won't be able to register your phone number using that modified WhatsApp again, and to some extent, it may also prevent you from installing the official WhatsApp as well. But in this tutorial, I will show you how you can fix this so that you can be able to use WhatsApp again. And if you find this video helpful, don't forget to give a thumbs up and also subscribe to my YouTube channel, turn on the notification bell so that I'll be keeping you posted with the latest updates. Now, in order for you to be able to fix this, the first solution is you need to have two different devices, the primary device and the secondary device. Now, the primary device is where you need to install the official WhatsApp, and the secondary device is the one where you're experiencing the error from. So on your primary device, you're going to head onto your Play Store app, search for WhatsApp Messenger, and then you install. After installing, you go ahead and register with the phone number through which you're experiencing the error in the secondary device. So after entering the phone number, then you go ahead and connect. And once it's successfully connected, then now you need to go to your secondary device, the one through which you're experiencing the error from, and then you make sure that you log out of that account and you install another WhatsApp application. So you can go to your Play Store or App Store, install WhatsApp. Now this time, instead of entering the phone number, you're going to click on the three dots at the top right corner, and then you select link as companion device or link as device, then it will generate a QR code. Then you go to your primary device, still you click on the three dots at the top right corner, then select linked devices. Then from there, you go ahead and select linked device, and then you scan the QR code on the secondary device. So you make sure that you allow permissions to the camera, then go ahead and scan the QR code on the secondary device. So once the scan is complete, your secondary phone's WhatsApp account will successfully be logged into the primary one, and in that way you can still be able to send or receive messages. And also, to ensure that linked devices are connected to your WhatsApp account, you will need to log into your primary phone every 14 days. So that is the first solution. Now the other second solution, in case you're not able to register or log into your WhatsApp account using the WhatsApp applications, is that instead of linking your WhatsApp account using the WhatsApp application, this time around you will need to link via a browser. So on your secondary device, you will need to go to your browser. For those using Android, you can use Chrome. So then on your browser, you're going to search for WhatsApp Web. So that is in case you're not able to access a laptop or computer, then still your phone can work. So go to the search bar and type WhatsApp Web, and then you enter, then you select the first option. So after selecting the first option, you need to ensure that you enable desktop site. So then after enabling desktop site, it will load the WhatsApp Web, and then now you can choose to connect with phone number or to link with the phone number. So then you go ahead and select that option, and then you'll be prompted to enter your phone number. So after entering the phone number, you select advance, then it will generate a code. Now this code is the one that you're going to enter into your primary device. So you're going to go and open your primary phone where the official WhatsApp is registered onto, and then now you click on the three dots at the top right corner, and then you select linked devices. And then you select link a device, then from the bottom or at the bottom you select link with phone number instead. Then it will bring a provision where you're going to copy this code. So then after entering the code, then it will automatically log in. And in that way, you will still be able to access WhatsApp via a web browser. and you'll still be able to send or receive messages. So these are the two solutions available, but in case there is an update, I'll let you know. So be sure to subscribe and keep the notification bell on, and see you in the next videos.